Is my screen visible? Can anyone confirm?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. Hello guys, we are going to start our workshop today. This is the workshop about APIs and Postman. So before we start, this is Sudeep Mandal from IIT Madras. I am the Postman student expert, and this event is sponsored by Postman. So you can contact me on LinkedIn, or most of you have my WhatsApp contacts. So let's start. So what is the agenda? What we are going to learn today? So you are going to learn about APIs and uses of APIs using Postman. So Postman is a tool which will allow you to use APIs. Now what is APIs? We will talk later, and how to use Postman, we will talk about it. So request and responses. So APIs has two components. So you don't know about APIs currently, but just to remember, APIs has two major components. One is requests and one is responses. Okay, and then we will having a trying out thing, like we will have a hands-on experience with the thing. And the because like the participants number is a little less now, so you can like just unmute yourself and you can ask if in doubt at any point. Because this is a very small amount of people attending, so we can make it as much as interactive possible. Then we will share some follow-up resources so you can practice on your own. And there will be a Q&A session that is also there, but you can ask in between also. So now, what is an API? Okay, so you can, if you have gone to a hotel or restaurant, so what is there? There is a safe, right? There is a safe and there is you. You are the person, you are the customer. And there is a waiter. So what if the waiter, there is no waiter in the restaurant? So you have to go to the safe and safe has to provide you the things, right? But you are not allowed in the kitchen. Okay, because if you go to the kitchen, like every customer goes in the kitchen and they will create a mess, right? So you cannot go to the kitchen. But you have to contact to safe. How do you contact? You cannot contact. So that's why we use a waiter. Waiters are one of the most important parts of a restaurant. Okay, obviously the customers and the safes are also important, but the waiters are as important as them. Okay, and the waiter doesn't do anything of their own. He is not paying. He is not cooking. So what is he doing? He is making the connection in between customers and the chef. So customer send it, customer asks for a food. Suppose he asks for biryani. Now he told the waiter that I want biryani. Waiter go to the chef and he tells like, we have to serve biryani. And chef serves the biryani to the waiter and waiter gives it to the customer. So that way the things work. Similarly, if you have the concept of servers and clients, so what are the servers? Servers, suppose take an example of Google. So Google is a server. Now suppose this is the meet. We are in a meet. Now I am talking. You are receiving my words, right? How it works? So there is a waiter who is taking my words, going to Microsoft server. Okay, what is server? Server is a computer hosted online. Like my computer is not hosted online. You cannot access my computer from your device, but we can access Microsoft's computer from our device, but the access is limited. It is not like you can access everything. It is like you can access your account details. You cannot access my account details, but both are stored in the same computer. So the same way APIs works, like there is a client. I am the client. Server is Microsoft's computer. There is an API. API is not a visible thing. API is just a thing, okay? Like just a thing, API. API is a connection. Now I cannot directly communicate with the server because if I have to communicate with the server directly, then I have to go to Microsoft Office and connect my computer with the USB. I cannot do that. So there is the API. Okay. So API works similarly as waiters. So if I go to Google's website and search for something, okay, I am searching for postman, and just Google serves me a web page that this is postman. He may tell like postman is a website where you can use APIs. They can tell me postman is a job which you can find in post office. So you can get both, but the thing is, how we like the data is stored in Google's computer. How we are getting that using APIs? Okay, there is the API thing. API works like this. Now, if we get into technical things, so APIs allow services to communicate each other. Like suppose I am making a website, okay, and so what are the most important things in website? Most of the websites use a authentication system, right? Like you have to create an account and you are going to work with that. So sometimes you may have seen like sign in with Google or sign in with Facebook or sign in with GitHub. So the things how we are using Google's sign in policy, right? So I cannot get your details directly from Google's computer. Okay, once you give me permission, then I am getting that. Now there is not a person sitting there 24/7, like every request coming for sign in and he is approving. No, not like that. Okay, there are some bots, and we communicate with the bots using the APIs. Okay, so we are not going like, how should we use those APIs, but how those API works. We are not going to code that API, okay, or we are not going to use every API there. There are many APIs, like for example, you can use Discord API, you can use Google's API, okay. And APIs are one of the like most important things in wireless internet connections. Like every connection, every internet connection, wireless internet connection you connect, that is through API. If you are searching for a website, that is also a API connection. Okay, that is not directly served from server, but you are sending a connection request to the server, and just the technical terms, the requests and responses. Now, suppose there is a technical thing. So there is an Instagram. Okay, you always all have used Instagram or Reddit or Facebook, similar things. Okay, so Instagram is most popular in IIT Madras. So I am just taking this example. So see, there is an Instagram. There is a post feed. Okay, so in every social media, there is a post feed, and your mobile has a camera. Okay, so what there happens? Instagram sends an connection ping to camera, saying that I want a photo, and camera responds back with the photo. Okay, then you post it and it goes to the news feed. Okay, so this is the thing from your point of view. Now I am a third person. Okay, I can see your post. So see, you can update the feed, I can see the feed. Those things are not same. Those are a little different. You are not seeing the feed. Like you can see the feed, but you, for this example, you are not seeing the feed. You are updating the feed or creating a post, and I am seeing the post. So this type of works. So these are different works. Okay. Now, like there are APIs for everything. So there are the cat API. Like you can make an API. I have made a lot of APIs. You can make APIs. Anyone having web development knowledge can make APIs, but there we are not like in the workshop, we are not going to teach you how to make APIs, but we are going to teach you how to use APIs. Okay. Now, basically, there is a cat API, open weather map. So what is open weather map? So if you go to like web development field, APIs are very much connected with web development and app development. So if you go in web development field, so the first API project, most probably you are going to do the weather project. Okay, like you are taking the location of your device, and it will be fetching the data of weather. It is getting the data of weather from someone, like NASA or ISRO website, and you are using that. Okay. There's Genius. So Genius, that is not very popular, but I don't know if you know. This works like you can search for lyrics of songs, and there are Discord, Spotify, Twitter, Facebook, Google. So these APIs you have used, like you have not used, but you have used the websites which uses these APIs, like sign in with Google or sign in with Facebook. And there is called YouTube to MP3, and like if you have used TubeMate or SnapTube, then these APIs are used there. Like they uses the link of YouTube video and they download the song or video for you. And there are like lots of APIs. Okay. So APIs. So I think you guys have a decent understanding what API does. Like why we need API. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me.
I have doubt.
Yeah, sure.
In that Instagram example, what was the API there?
Okay, so the APIs is like there are two APIs used. Okay, one is offline API and one is online API. The offline API is the camera API. Okay, so Instagram sends a request to camera saying that I need a photo, and camera sends the response to you. Okay, like camera sends like you are the Instagram. Okay, I am the camera. So you are asking me, send me photo. I am sending you photo. One API connection is there. Okay, the connection is the API. Okay, like in the restaurant, the waiter was the connection, and here the web signals are the API. Okay, like you and me are connecting. I am camera. You are Instagram. We are connecting. So we are connecting through something, right? We are talking. Okay, so that is the API.
Okay.
And similar thing happens when you send the text, like send the post to news feed. Okay, you are posting the photo. So how will you communicate with Instagram servers? Like there is Instagram server. You have to send the photo to Instagram server so they can serve it to everyone, right? So how are you connecting with that? That is the API. API is not a real thing. Like API is like there is a website. You can tell like this is a website. I can see it, right? You can see a server. Okay, like this is the server. This is the computer. We can see it, but you cannot see the API. API is the connection in between this.
Okay. So API is like a medium between the communication.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Understood.
Okay, so let's know how APIs work. So API turns the software into Lego bricks. Like suppose I am making it was my earlier app development project. I'm talking about it. So it was basically a thing that is you can you are mountaineering, you are going for a trek, and you need a guide. Okay, so I made an app that will guide you. So what was the things? So I cannot guide you. I don't know about trekking, right? I cannot guide you. I know how to make apps. So what I did, I used one API to collect your location, your current location. Okay, that is an offline API. It collects your location using the GPS or your Wi-Fi location, something like that. Okay, then I used an API which gets the weather location and longitude and latitude. Okay, then I get the data. Like I collected your location, and using the location I collected your weather and oxygen level and all. And then there was an API and different API. Okay, these three APIs are created by three different persons, and I connected it with an API which will take the oxygen level, the temperature, and this, and suggest you what to do. Okay, so I don't know about any of the three things. I don't know the location, the how to collect the weather of a location, because I don't have satellites. Okay, and I also don't have a machine learning algorithm generate the suggestions. But someone made it. I used the three things and created an app. Okay, so like I just connected the like you can like understand it like a Lego bricks. I am just connecting the Lego bricks one upon one, and it the app is made. Okay. Now, why Postman and what is Postman? So Postman is a visual tool to use APIs. Okay, like to debug APIs and to understand APIs. You can understand it like like Google Drive. Okay, so Google Drive is very popular, right? Because it has a good UI of like you can have data stored anywhere, and you might have sent command line instructions, and like it may be harder for you. Okay, but like you have to go to websites and search for it. That is not like Google Drive has a very decent experience, and Postman creates the same thing. Like it creates a very decent experience when you use an API. So it like in the left hand side, the thing before Postman. Okay, what we did before Postman, where there was no Postman, we used to check APIs this way, and we didn't understand it. Okay, and in the right side you can see the Postman, the same APIs, and you can see like there we can get the HTML. You can see right there is the HTML. If you know HTML, then you can understand that this is a HTML. There is a script tag and this. And you can there is a visualize option, so you can go and visualize also. So now what are the requests and responses? So I have already told like there are two main things in an API. One is request and one is response. So there is a client and there is server. So once more, client is my computer, not only my computer, specifically my browser. Okay, or if I am using an app, then my app. Okay. Or my desktop app maybe, whatever, like for simplicity's sake, let's talk about like my computer is a client and the server is suppose Google's computer. Okay, now from client, I am telling I have to search something. Like I am searching in Google search engine. I am searching for something like laptop. So I send a request. So I in the search bar, I am writing laptop. It sends a request to the Google server. Google server evaluates the request like, oh, this guy search laptop. So there are the things we have about laptop, and sends a response to the client. Okay, like I am getting the next page, the thing I searched. And how to make requests? Okay, so there are three things. One is method, address, and path. So what is address? First let's talk about address. So when I hope you all are from India. If you are abroad, then okay, but like for India, when we search in Google, normally we search in www.google.co.in. okay, so this is the address, this is the endpoint. Now there are paths. Okay, so what is a path? Path is a thing like let's go to an API, just see some APIs. So you can see there is if I open my Google. Okay, so it is saying mail.google.com. This is the endpoint. Okay, mail.google.com. These are the path /mail/u/0. So this is my personal email. If I change it to /1, okay, instead of /0, if I put it /1, then you can see it is my institute email. Okay, so these are the paths. If I go to /2, then it will be another personal email for me. Okay, so that's why it works. And these are the things. So I think you understood what is address and path, right? Anyone having doubts in address and path till now? Okay, so I take it as like no doubts. Now there is a method thing. Okay, so what is method? So you can see there are the two names, get and post, in my screen. Okay, so what are the get method and what are the post methods? So post methods is when you are sending some data to the website or to the server. Like if you are posting something on YouTube or you are posting something on Instagram, so you are making a post request and I am seeing the video, I am seeing the YouTube video, so I don't make there a post request, I send there a get request, because I am not sending a data, I am just getting a data. Is it clear? Okay, I take it as yes. And like there are many type of method, and so we will check them one by one. Get and posts are the most most popular. Like you can, if you know about get and post, you can have anything. Okay, now when we use browser, okay, when we use browser, we also like connecting some, like if I am using Google, okay, so if I am using Google and I am searching something, I am connecting to the server, right? So there is also an API, because the connection is the API. So what request we made? I know the path. Okay, I know the address. I know the path. There is the path. But what method we use? So just remember this. Whenever you are using browser directly, the address bar of the browser or search bar of the browser, you are always making a get request. You cannot send a data through this. Through address bar, you can send data through website, because websites has embedded JavaScript in this, but you cannot directly send data using this address bar or search bar, whatever you say. Okay, and so this is to remember, browsers always send get request. So if you are making an API and you are bothering how to send a post request, obviously use Postman. So you can send get request using Postman also. So see, there are the method. So you can see here is the method. Okay, get, post, push, put, patch, delete. You can use anything. And then you can see the google.com is the basically endpoint, and the search is the path. Okay, so and this is a protocol. I think you know, like the thing here is a protocol. It is hypertext transfer protocol, and if you use TCP/IP, then also you can use, but depends on the website. So this is the basically host or address or endpoint, what you say, and this is the path. Path can be very long, like search, then slash, then slash, then slash. It may be very long. Okay, the slash is separating between paths. Okay, then there are the parameters, then authorization and headers. So what is a parameter? So if we go to the request I send in Google again, so you can see there is something question mark, and then Q equal to this, BTNK equal to this, S, X, or something. So if you have programmed in any language, you are familiar with the term parameters, right? Where we use parameters, when we write a function, we have to send some arguments, that we call parameters. And these are the parameters. Like we need a Q. So Q stands for query. Like what is the search query? This is the search query. BTNK, what is the button clicked? The Google search button or something. Okay. So these are the things. Maybe for Yahoo search button, the results will be different. And so these are the parameters. Then authorization. So for sometimes we need authorization when we are sending requests. Suppose I am writing www github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github.github not seeing this page. But if you write the same thing, www.github.com, you will be seeing a different page, right? This is because my account is different than your account. Okay, like page will be same, but the contents will be different. And there the authorization is hidden. Okay. And there the headers. The headers are also there, headers and body. So headers and body is the data we want to send when we are posting something. We are posting an Instagram post. So that is a body. Okay, and headers are the things where we store some cookies. Okay, like we can use cookies, we can store authorization also. So if you are using an Amazon cart, you can, like if you refresh the page, the cart doesn't go because it is stored in your browser using a cookie and it sends the data to the website. Okay. And then requests body. So bodies are sent when we use post or put request, because in get request we are not sending a data. Bodies are used when we send a data. So like it can be an image. So you might have familiar with JSON. It is a very standard body data type. Okay, and also form is a very popular. Okay, if you had used HTML, then you have seen there is a tag called form. So that is used for sending form data. And JSON is nothing but JavaScript object. So if you have used Python, then you have seen dictionary. And if you have used JavaScript, then obviously you have seen JSON. So those are pretty much same. And JSON is the JavaScript object. So because in the web browser, you can only run JavaScript and TypeScript. So we have to we should use JSON as in JSON as a standard thing. Okay. And there are also like HTML. So if you are using, you are sending, like you are going to a website, like I went to github.com. So it in the response, I got a HTML. Right. If you are using an app, in the response, you get an XML. So that is the thing. So we will talk about JSON data today, because JSON is very much standard. You can try out other types also. If you are familiar with GraphQL, then you can try also that. But I think if you are familiar with GraphQL, then this workshop will be very beginner friendly for you. Then this is the JSON. So you can see if you had used JavaScript, then you must have seen JSON. But if you have used Python, then also it is similar to a dictionary, right? There is a key and there is a value, and the keys will be unique, but the values may be common. Now, if anyone have any doubts till requests, please tell me. Okay, I will take it as a positive response. So now status codes, right? So responses. So responses comes with three major parts. One is status codes, one is headers, and one is body data. So what is body data? Body data is the data we get from the server. Like maybe it may be an HTML. So what was the your body data and the request? The same body data is in the response. It can be JSON, it can be HTML, it can be XML, it can be GraphQL, everything. Then there is a header. So we can get headers, like we can get a cookie from the server side. Okay, or we can get anything from the server side. So that is the headers. Then status codes. Okay, so status codes. So I think most of you are familiar with 404, right? That is when you are putting a wrong URL. So you get 404, that the website is not found. And 200 is status code okay and 201 is created. So to like when it doesn't show any errors, so you can assume that it is in or then it is error from your side, and if it is starting from 5, then it is an error from server side. Okay, like this digit I am talking about, the 4 or 2. And so these are the common things. I think you guys have understood what is the things. If you have any doubts, please ask, unmute and tell. Okay, I take it as a positive response. So now we are going to have an hands-on experience. So I will share the link in the chats, so you can just join. Okay, so why it will show specifically 404? Because whoever wrote the code, he wrote like it will show 404. Okay, and it is a pretty rule, you can avoid it, but it is a pretty standard thing. When you are giving a wrong URL, we are going to show you 404. Okay, that is everyone follows. Like we will show 404 when you are giving a wrong URL, and basically that's why everyone uses 404. You can like show 200 when it is wrong, but that is not good because 200 browser will think like the status is okay, but why I'm not getting the response. So that way the things works, and this is just pretty convincing. It is 404, not 405 or not 204. This is just pretty much convincing. Everyone follows this rule. So I am sending you the link here for API workspace. So you can just. So I hope you have already created an account and on API, on Postman. So you can just see this workshop link. So in the chats, if anyone is unable to access, please let me know. I will start at 1 minute. Okay, I will just give you 1 minute to get to this page. Okay, just click the link and you will get to this page. If anyone having any difficulty, please let me know. I hope everyone is currently in this page. Please follow along because it will help you a lot. If you are just listening, then I don't know if you can remember everything. You have to go through the recording again and again. If you practice with me, we can like get through better. Okay, so one suggestion, you can just split your screen like this way. Okay, and you can like one hand you can just see my screen and other hand you can just use the Postman. Okay, so I am just keeping it full screen so you can follow along easily. So what you need to do first, so you have to create a fork first, because you are not allowed to use this workspace because everyone will be using this. I am using this, you are using this, so you have to create a fork first, and you have to take the collection, take the thing to your workspace. So you are only the only one who is going to use that. So create a fork, put a label. So I am just putting API 101 workshop. And search your brand, choose my workspace, okay? And fork collection. So what, see, you can see the documents here, documentation here. So this is called a documentation. So you don't know who created this API, right? So whom, how do you know how to use this? Because you think, because there are the paths, right? Now, how do you know it is joke or jokes or joker? Anything it can be, it is just text. So for this, we write a documentation. We write something so you can read it and use it. So I will teach you how to use the documentation, how to learn the documentation. So we will be going with the jokes. Okay. Now, this is there is the link. There is the link. You have to use the link. This is called an endpoint. So if I just click on this, this is hosted on Heroku, so it will be a little slow. So this is like in the endpoint, it is showing hello world. But if I go further in the path, like if I write joke, it is giving me a joke. Okay, author not available, joke. First rule of programming, if it works, don't touch it. Source is this. And if I refresh the page, it is giving me another joke. Okay, so if you are, suppose you are making a fun website, and there you want to have random jokes, then you can use this API. You don't have to create an API, like you have don't have to find for jokes, and you have to don't need to do that. You can just use this API and just put in it in your website. Now, how will you use this? I will not going to teach you right now, because I am not going to teach you web development. I am going to how to play with the API. Okay, so this is the browser, and I am sending, I already told you, if I using browser, then I am sending get request, right? So just take this, copy this, and go to your workspace. There's a thing, and add the URL here. So I'm adding the URL here and sending a get request. So it is sending me a, sending me a JSON response. Okay, if I send the request again, it is so this is the request. Okay, this part is a request, this part, like this part. Okay, this upper part is the request and the lower part is the response. So you can see, like I got 8 headers. I didn't get any cookies, but I got 8 headers. There is no test result because I have not set any test. Now, if I send again, I will get, I got that only. So I if I send again, then I got another joke. Okay, so this is the get request. Anyone have any doubt till now? Please let me know. Hello, am I audible? Okay. Yeah. How did you open the request? So, see, go to this, like you can see this, right? This basics of API, this part you can see, right? After, have you able, can you unmute just? Okay, I think there is some problem in your mic side. Okay, so if you create a fork, okay. So if you create a fork, then you can see this. I hope you have created the fork, right? Yeah, so you can see this. Then you can click on the drop down icon. There is the drop down icon, and you can get this part. This is called a get data. So you can click on that. Like at first, if you click on this, it will show like this. Okay. And if I open this part, then there is the link. So this link is opened there. So if I go to this part and copy this link, okay, slash joke. So copy this link, /joke, okay, and send it. There is the request. Okay. So I think you all got the responses. If anyone is unable to get any response, please let me know. Okay, cool. Then okay, then see, there is the workspaces option, and you can go to the Postman Student API workspace again. And we are going to see the next part is basics of API with auth. Okay, so what is auth? It's authentication. Auth is a short form of authentication. So if I create a fork again, the process is same. I am just writing API 101 workshop, and location is my workspace. Created the fork. The steps are same. The only thing is we have to add an authentication. We have to add a username and password. And for now, just take it like they have not set any like limitations of username and password. So just you can put any username and password. Okay, that don't matter for now, because this is, but if you are using Google, then the username and password matters. So I am writing username as Sudeep and password as 123. Okay, and it is saved. Okay, and then I am writing get data, and then add your URL from notebook. So where did I get the URL? You can see there is the button. There is called documentation. So this is the URL. This is the endpoint. Just copy this. Copy this. Put it here and send. So I got a response, and the username and password is basically like you can understand like username and password, but there is no restriction on this right now because this is a practice workspace. But for some workspace, only Sudeep and 123 will work, and other username password won't work. Okay, so that is not practice thing, but this is practice thing. So I think these two parts you got it. If any doubts, please let me know. Okay, I take it like no doubts. Okay, let's go ahead. And so I will check the and then there is the building an API. Okay, so it is not building, like there is the name. APIs are built with codes or tools. We are not going to build an API like coding, but we are going to use the API, and like the get request, the post request, the put request, and patch request. Okay, so here if we open the documentation, so this is just a simple get request. So what it does, if I send the request, it is sending like this is the message, this is the headers. Okay, like this is basically sending everything, like every data. Like it is breaking down your request. The message is this, like this is the arguments, and then this is the headers, URL is this. Okay, this is the thing. Now the get joke. So to get the joke, what we have to do, as I already shown you, we have to take this and send a get request. Okay, so this is sending, this you have already seen, right? So I am not going to explain it furthermore. Now get into the post request. So when we use post request, we use post request if we have to send a data. So we are going to post a joke. So just let the same URL. Now there is something is slash pin. It will be your ID. Okay, for me, I am just sending an ID of Sudeep 100 2023. Okay, that's it. And there will be a body. So there is, you can post a joke. So I am just posting, like, this is a just simple text. I am posting like, hi, I have found C++ very easy. Okay, so this is a joke, and I am just writing the source is sleep, and author also, let's keep it sleep. And then I have to send it post request. See, that this is a post request, this is not get request. Earlier it was get request, but this is now post request. So if I send this, I think there is some error. Okay, sorry. So this will be only number, I guess. So just keep it 100. That also not working. Okay, 1 minute. I think that I have copied the wrong link, maybe. One minute, I will just check it. But maybe this is tricky. I think it worked, but there is no response. But okay. So for this, now let's see what all the jokes are there currently. Book is not here. Okay, 1 minute. I just I think this will be the end point. Okay, so this postmanstudent.heroclub.com/joke, and this will be the format of the JSON. I think it is not updated yet from the server side, and this is some sending some errors. And now if I refresh this page, you can see this is my joke is here, right? So now you can also post, just post. Okay, whoever following with me, is a fork is like a file where it stores out. So what is a fork? So 1 minute, I will explain that very easily. I will explain the fork once. Okay, so fork is a very important concept when you are using options in the collection, not any other. You go to this workspace, you see, you go to this workspace, Postman workspace, and you have to, like, there are four collections. I will be explaining the first three, and you have to fork this as well. You have to fork each and every one. Like, you can create a fork. You have to fork this workspace also. Naveen Chintu, please tell me if this worked for you. And I will tell you why fork is important, what is a fork. So guys, have you used a thing in Google Drive called make a copy in your drive? Have you used this? Siddhartha Gugulotu. Sorry, yeah. Okay. So, okay, I will explain you. What is a fork? Suppose I have created a project, okay? And I don't know you. I created the project and I hosted it online. Like, this project code is online. Now I don't know you. And you tell me, like, you can improve the project. Now I don't know you. You may be my friend, you may be my enemy. You can come and destroy my project, and you can come and help me a lot. How I will understand, like, you are going to help me? So I won't give you the access project. Copy this project on your own. Okay, make a, like, just take the code on your own, update the code, and send me back. This is something. I have a Word file. I send you. You download it, change it, and send me back again. So this is done by a fork. Fork is something. This is my project. You are copying the thing to your project, like, to making it as your project. This is called forking. And the next part, where you are merging it to my project, it is called merging. Okay. So this is a fork. Now the workspace, I have sent the link. So everyone is going to use that workspace. Everyone, I am a student expert. Every student expert is going to use that workspace. So they won't allow you to change it, to modify it. Right. That's why you need to create a fork. So that you can work it on your own, but that won't affect you. Okay, and okay, Naveen Chintu, like, is the problem fixed for you? All the collection?
No. If I'm clicking the plus means it is showing new collection only, but it's not showing the what we have.
So see, follow along with me. There is the workspace button. Go to Postman Student API 1.1 workshop. You found it, this part?
Wait. In workspaces, I'm able to see my workspace, that's it.
My workspace, okay. So you can go to the chat here, and there is a link I have sent, this link. Can you see my screen, this link?
Yes, yeah.
Click on that and you will land here. Have you found it?
Yeah, where is the link?
Oh, okay. So I will send the link again then. Okay, I am just tagging it, okay. I pinned it. See, there is a pinned message. Got it in the chats, or I will send again.
Send again. Okay. I'm able to see now.
Yeah. So now go to this part, and there is an option called create a fork. There are the three dots in front of it. Create a fork and just put it any level, and location is your my workspace. Okay. And then you will land to your workspace. And there is the building and API. Okay. So anyone else posted something till? Hello. So I am posting again. Okay. I am showing you how to post again. So I am sending.
Yeah. So show us once more time. I was not able to get that time.
Yeah. So I sent the link to the chat. This is the endpoint and path where we have to send it. So just paste the link in this part. Make sure this is post request. Then give an ID. ID something, okay, like 20 or something. Like, don't put same IDs. Put a different ID. Then any number, any random number, 100, 200, anything. And then just you can change the author. You can change the source. You can change. You may not change. You can change the joke. I am just changing it. Hi, I am Sudeep. Okay. So like, if you like write like this, hi, I am your name, then I can see whoever posted these things. Okay. Then you have to just simply send it. Now the response is made such way like it is sending my joke itself. But now if I go here and I just refresh it, you can see my joke is here in this page. So everyone try it. If it goes wrong, I will try to figure it out. If you don't try it, it may go wrong later on.
After create forking, we have to go to the post add data option, right?
Yeah. I have some background noise, maybe. Sorry for that. So is it done? Like, have you tried? Anyone got any error? Okay, I got. Okay. I think you guys have tried it. Okay, nice. So everyone. So I think you guys understood how post request is working. Okay. So you don't know where is the database. We are sending like, I know if I send there and I use this way, then it will be showing here, right? So suppose this is the Instagram feed. Okay. And I am creating an Instagram. So I can show this is my Instagram feed. And I am sending data here by using this. Okay. How will you do this? You have to learn web development or app development to understand all the things. How to make this website or something. Okay, you have to learn web development. But if you know web development or don't know web development, how to use APIs, how to use Postman, you can learn using this. Okay. Now you can update the data. Okay. So how to update the data? The same URL, but the request is put here. Okay, the request is put, and for the body, I am just copying this. And I am just changing the message, right? Changing the message to updated the data. And if I send now, I hope it worked. I don't know if it worked, but let's refresh it. Didn't work, it seems. Let's send it again. Okay, I think it is updated, but the older one didn't deleted, right? Or okay, I have sent two data. I have sent two data. Okay, that's why. Like for which one updated? Hi, I am Sudeep is updated. So you got it? No, everyone got it. Got this point. Okay, I think let's do it once more. Okay. Hello. I am trying to fix the confusion. Okay, so this is add data. This is add data. So what will it do? It will create a new joke. Okay, joke with I20 already exists. So I am just sending 25 then. Send, and it will be creating here. If I refresh this page, so. Hello, I am trying to fix the confusion. And then if I go to the update data and if I write fixed the confusion and send this. And now see this. If I refresh it, okay, I think something is not correct in the, something is wrong in the server side from the post. This is postman's thing. I think there is some problem, like this is replicating somehow, or I don't know, but let's try it once more. If it doesn't work, then we will leave it last time. Let's try it last time, and please 300 and send it.
You're doing an add data, no? You have to update data.
Yeah, no, yeah. So like,
so you're using add data thing. We have to update now. Yeah.
Now I added it for last time. Like this is the data. It should be updated. So if I go to the update data, and I am taking it 300. That's last time. Okay, this is. I hope it will update. Yeah, this is updated now. Okay, so there were some problems because I am basically I was giving a wrong ID, maybe that's what the problem. But okay, I think the confusion is clear, right? Or in no confusion words are there, maybe. Okay, so yeah, I gave ID 20. Yes, that's what the thing. I had to give the ID 25. Now there's a delete data. Now not only adding data works, but Instagram has a thing called delete post option also, right? So we have to delete the posts also. So this is the URL, and there's a delete request, and in the body I will send raw data Then ID. This will be in quotations. Okay, give it quotations. Wait, I think we have to send it this way. Okay, but 300. Let's check it. It works. Joke with ID 300 is deleted. Let's check now. This should be deleted, right? This is fix it. This should be deleted. This deleted. Fix it, deleted, right? Let's read my other things also. So whatever like jokes you have created, try to delete them. Let's try to delete them. Okay, I'm sending joke with ID 20 deleted. Joke with ID 25 deleted. And now if I refresh this, so just everyone delete your what was this for? Maybe 11. Okay, just others also delete there. Let's check it, like if everyone learning it. The five jokes just delete. Okay, I think either they are not deleting or maybe they left the meat. But this is the thing, okay? So I think you have got a decent idea how Instagram works. So this is not the way, like Instagram doesn't have Postman within it. There are ways to write the APIs inside JavaScript code, but how the developers, like someone, so you have a concept of backend and frontend, I guess. So someone is writing the codes on server and someone is writing the codes on browser. Now, whoever using the codes on server, they have to test their APIs, right? So this is the way they test it. This is not used in the apps or in the websites. This Postman is not used, but during the making of the web apps and website, Postman is used. I think I made my point clear. You guys got it, no? How do we add this API to our website now? So so this is not a web development workshop, but because I know it, I will tell you. So if you use JavaScript, then I am sorry for this. Okay, so if you use JavaScript, then there is a function called fetch. There is a function called fetch. You can use that function to get the data, get the JSON data from the API. Okay, but don't use this API because this is not a public API. This is like, so anyone can delete your, like if you are making a app and you are getting jokes from here, anyone can delete your jokes or anyone can, you got it, know what I am telling to say. And this is like, if you want to like use an API, if you want to use an API, so you can find like other APIs on GitHub. Search for jokes API in Google and you will get the APIs which are good, like which are professionally made to get jokes. Okay, and this is the thing for today, but I as I told, like there will be some contests, you can take part and you can get swags. So just a recap. So what are the things, methods? The method is get, post, put, page, delete. Okay, for standard, where we use get, when are we getting a data? Where we use post, where we are adding some data? When we hit put, when we are trying to update some data? When we use delete, when we are trying to delete some data? Okay. Now addresses at the endpoint, the google.com or something. Then the thing is paths. So this is the slash search or slash joke, that is. Then there are the parameters, that is the question mark, and there is Q equal to Sudeep. So Q is a parameter and Sudeep is its value. And then authorization, so you know username and password, that is authorization, and it may have the cookies or tokens, anything. For body data, is the basically what we are sending. Like we are posting jokes, then we are sending some JSON. Okay. And you can just if you want to learn more, and if you want to be a student expert, you can apply for a student expert. Okay. Just go to the Google, and I will share the links to how to apply for Google student expert at Postman. And what you have to do, you have to go to student expert, and you have to complete an assignment, and you will get the badge, and you can just declare that you are a student expert. It is very easy. This is not very hard. So this is, I will send the link. In LinkedIn, Facebook, Medium, Blogspot, in any platform you want, then tag with hashtag Postman Student and hashtag Postman API. Okay, and I will share a link to the form, link of a form, and you have to submit the things like what was the link. And we will judge on the basis how many reacts you got, how is really your content is. Okay, like if you are getting 1,000 reacts, then and someone is getting 10 reacts, and your both the content is similarly good, then we will prefer the 1,000 react person. But suppose you are getting 1,000 reacts on a dummy post, because you are like suppose you Insta influencer, and you are getting 1,000 reacts on a dummy post, but someone has written it well and it didn't get it, then we will give the, so this is a judging criteria. There are no hard judging criteria. We will share one t-shirt to the winner, so from Postman. Okay, so this is the thing. So just submit the URL, and obviously you have to submit the feedback form. You will not get any rewards if you have not submit the feedback form, because the feedback form is the attendance itself. So just share in Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, anywhere. So I will share these links, so you can learn about Postman and how to work with them. So if you have any doubts, there is a Q&A session, but I think you have asked already everything. But if you have any doubts as such, yeah, I will share these slides. I will share this slide. If you have any doubts, please let me know. Okay, I think pretty much decent, because you all have asked throughout the session. So thank you for joining, and there will be feedback form. I will share this. You can email me, and most of you have my WhatsApp also, so you can WhatsApp me as well if you have any doubts regarding APIs and Postman. I think you have enjoyed the session a lot, and because I am not a pro workshop host. Okay, so if there are some problems, please like forgive me. Okay, I apologize, but I think thank you for joining, and thank you from Postman, thank you from GitHub, thank you from our organization as well. Have a nice day.